Dear student, this is the second chapter for the second term syllabus. That is chapter 8, class 9 economic application, chapter 8, environment, and the name of the chapter is environment and agriculture. So before we begin this chapter, let me just little explain about the ecosystem, the meaning of ecosystem. And as the chapter is dealing with the environment and agriculture, we have to first of all know the meaning of ecosystem. That, what is the meaning of ecosystem and why it is really being related with the chapter of this environment and agriculture. So the term ecosystem was proposed by Tansley in 1953. So he must be one of the environmentalists who has given this meaning of ecosystem. So here, as he said, an ecosystem is an ecological unit consisting of both biotic and abiotic factor existing in the environment, which means an ecosystem, according to him, an ecosystem is an ecological unit consisting both living organism and non-living organism. So what happened, this element of this element and environment are inseparably, they are interrelated and are interactive in their nature. They cannot be separated. They are always related to each other. That's why an ecosystem is an any special or organizational unit which include living organism and non-living substance interacting to produce an exchange of material between the living and non-living elements, which means this ecosystem is a consisting of both living and non-living organisms, which are very much essential, and they are interacting to produce and to bring exchange of material between the living and non-living element. So the concept of ecosystem, provides the central theoretical framework for ecological, which says that the concept of ecosystem will provide or provide the central theoretical framework for ecological. Newer studies are quantifying different components of ecosystem structure and function so that they depend relationship and more precisely understood. Now, this in regards to India, let us see the ecological imbalances. And there are some factors. What is the reason behind the imbalance of this ecological problem? So in India, there are many development for the economic development the government of India has undertaken for bringing this ecological imbalance. When we talk about the ecological imbalance, means what? The environment, the ecosystem, which is not properly balanced, which means one side will be less, one other side will be more. So due to this imbalance, the government of India has taken many steps to bring the development in this imbalance of ecosystem in India. So India has launched a number of economic plans since the adoptions of the new development strategy. So the government of India has brought up many economic plans for this development strategy. These economic plans have resulted in substantial expansions of agriculture and industrial sector. See, this economical plan, or this economic plan, which has been initiated to bring the balance of ecological in India, has really developed in the agriculture and industrial sector, along with the expansion of other infrastructural facilities. So, what are there are some factors that has brought to this to the imbalance of ecological imbalance of India. So some of the factors that I'm going to write and explain to you, you can just see to that. Factors See, factors in detail for ecological imbalance in India. So what the first factor is what? The first factor is degradations degradations of land and soil erosions. See here, the factors is what? The first is degradations of land and soil erosions. Degradation of land and soil erosion, which is that Ministry of Agriculture, Government of India has reported about the serious problem of land degradations and soil erosions in the following heads. So if you see in the book, page number 94, you will see that a table that shows the degradations of land and soil erosions. Here, if you look into the box, you'll see that there are eight points that from point number 1 to 8, and the right side box, you'll see that area in millions of hectares has been degraded. So what is this? In this table, it reveals that about 176 million hectares, that is 53% of the total land area in India, is facing the serious problems of land degradations. And 150 million hectares is subjected to soil erosion through water and wind, and the remaining 26 million hectares is subjected to other problems. So not only the degradation of land and soil erosions, other than that, there are many other factors that have that brings the imbalance of ecological in India. Then the second point is deforestation. This forestation is what? Deforestation is, in the simple language, we can know that the clearing or the cutting down of trees in a vast area, in a big area, for the agricultural purpose or for any industrial development purpose or for any housing purpose. So here, deforestation is also being one of the causes or factors that has brought to the imbalance of the ecological problem in India. Large scale of deforestation has been continued since independence. Since independence, large scale of forest has been destroyed. And due to over-exploitation of forest resources, during the first 2 decades of planning in India has lost about 2.4 million hectares of forest. Since after the independence, or after the 2 decades means what? During the first 2 decades of planning, India has lost more than 2.4 million hectares of forest land, out of which about 70% of that area was lost due to river barrier project. And out of that, roads and communications and industries for making all this purpose, the land has been destroyed or the forest has been destroyed. Deforestation is still continuing now. It is not stopping situations. It go on happening now and then also. So it is a continuing at a rapid scale, and the problem has reached to such a proportion that it has totally distributed the ecological balance of the country. This is what the deforestation is talking about. And the third one, and the third point is, and the third point is faulty utilization of The third factor is what? The faulty utilization of water resources. Faulty utilization means not proper utilization or not planned utilization of water resources. What happened is, being one of the most wettest country, means India is one of the most wettest country, but still India is still facing flood and drought due to the defective utilization of resources. Due to not proper utilization of resources, we are, even though our country is the wettest place, wettest country in the world, still then we are facing flood and drought because we are not properly utilizing the resources what we have in our hand. So, since independence, too much importance was laid on the development of big dams. After the independence, that means after the 1947, the government of India is planning of so much of developing on the dams. But this has displaced crores of tribal people, making a big dams. What happened? What do we see? Due to the making of big dams for the development purpose, what happened is that the people, mostly the tribal people, drowning million sector of these forest areas are to prevent and control flood that often create destructive flash flood to the downstream valley. Besides this, what happened? The huge dam multi-purpose project have created a environment impact in the form of degradations of soil in the common area. So due to this, what happened? Water logging happened, and increase in soil salinity also goes away. So due to this, what happened? It brings the problems of imbalance in ecological system. And the fourth point is environmental problems from faulty practices. Environmental problems from faulty practices. From the faulty practices, as I've said, due to excessive or due to large scale of extractions of mineral that has created the another serious problems to the environmental. So now ruining the country land, water, forest and air. That is what it happens, or it brings a problem to the environmental or ecological problems in India. So these are what, due to what problems? These environmental problems from the faulty practices, what? Large scale of mining that also has resulted in the conversions of agriculture and forest land into a stockyard. So due to the large scale of mining, digging of earth and destroying the agriculture and the forest land into a useless land, that is what we say, that is converted into stockyard and township roads, railways and lines. And we also remove, due to that problems, due to the mining, we also remove vegetations and the topsoil. So because of this, what happened? As a result of this, what happened is that it resulted in the large scale of deforestation. Due to mining, what happened? The forest has been destroyed. And as a result of destruction of the forest, what happened next? The soil erosion also take place, and is also responsible for various health hazards to human beings. Not only the destructions of the soil, land, forest, and not only that brings imbalance to the ecological system, rather than that, it also brings some harmful effect to the human being in the form of respiratory problems and other illness. And for today, let us do the last point. There are many factors. Even then, I'll do till five factors. The last one for this factor industrial and atmospheric pollution. This says that industrial and atmospheric pollution, these also bring a harmful or imbalance to the ecological system in India. That is what unplanned and uncontrolled growth of industries and ill-maintained automobiles are creating huge atmospheric pollution problem. This is what the automobiles or any growth of industries are not properly maintained. And because these are not properly maintained, due to that, what happened? It brings a very huge burden to the atmospheric problems and it creates the pollution problem. They also what? This air pollution includes what? They include carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, oxide of nitrogen, sulfur dioxide, and metallic traces. Again, what happened next? Some specific pollutants are also being mixed with the atmosphere, which include lead from automobiles, nuclear power stations, etc. And as a result of this, what happened? A constant being discharged. That means what? From all these waste, from the industrial waste or factories, this affect the rivers, lake, and seas, and creating huge problem to the human health and for the populations of the country. Now, next, let us talk on. Let us talk on impact of agriculture practice on the ecosystem. That means what? What are the results that happens on the practice of agriculture on the ecosystem? This is another topic from this. What are the impact of agricultural practices on ecosystem? For developing the agricultural sectors, for developing and improving and for the growth of economy, we practice agriculture. So practicing this agricultural factors on the ecosystem has many impact. What are those impact? Let us see one by one. The first one is construction of dam. Construction of big dams for the development, for the purpose of agricultural development, what happened? There is a loss of habitat species. Loss of habitat. See, for bringing development on the agriculture, it has many impact on ecosystem. The first one, when we try to build construct a dam for the agricultural productions or for the agricultural development, what happened? There are a loss of habitat species. When we say of loss of habitat species, means what? Those living place or the place where the species or different kind of species live, the place has been destroyed due to the construction of them. So that is what river possess a delicate ecological that depends on a regular cycle of disturbance within certain tolerance limit. So the plant and animal communities that inhabited in the rivers, that inhabitants in rivers are river margins have evolved to adopt the river own peculiar pattern of flood and drop, slow and fast current, dams, disrupt this ecological system. So what happened that the construction of dams and the flooding of valleys for power generations, the use of pesticide, toxic contaminations of soil have also been associated with unintended species extinction. So because of this construction of dams and many other things for the agricultural development purpose, what happened is that it extinct, the species get extinct from the world. So the first effect of dam is what? It is to alter the pattern of disturbances that the plant and animals of the river have evolved for. Next is what? After the constructions, the impact on the construction of agriculture, first point is the construction of dam, and the second is loss of topsoil. Loss of topsoil. So, what happened? When these constructions happen, or when the construction of dams happen, what happened? The top layer of the soil get washed away, or it happens that some of the fertility of the soil also gets spoiled. What we see is that the top layer of the soil has always contained a rich organic matter or good amount of mineral nutrients are present there. So when the agriculture is being practiced by which crops are produced on a large scale by farmer, this is the primary occupations of people in a country and governs the economy to a great extent. But unfortunately, what happened is that certain natural factors and agricultural practice are disturbing the topmost layer of the soil. Due to the practice of this agriculture and other farming factors has disturbed or has degraded the top layer of the soil and made the field infertile. And this is also called soil erosions and degradations. And the next one is what? Soil erosions. We know that soil erosion is nothing the washing away of the top layer of the soil, but however, this also have a big impact on the imbalancing of the ecosystem. So soil erosion is the greatest single problem to the country prosperity. When the soil erosion is happening or take place, that has a big problems or big issues to the country prosperity. It means that the cutting away of the valuable topsoil, plant fruits, nutrition by natural agencies like rain, wind current, etc. This causes a big problem to the ecosystem. So soil erosion is an important symptom of bad relations between people and soil, just as a headache is often a symptom of some more fundamental illness. So now, let me just give you some points on the causes of soil erosion. What causes the soil erosion? Point number one. Intensive agriculture. Point number two, zoom farming. Point number three, nature of crops. Four, faulty land use practices. And point number five, indiscriminate cutting of trees. So these are the points of causes of soil erosions. First is what? This is not agriculture, irrigations. The first one is intensive irrigations. What happened is that due to the intensive use of the land for the agriculture purpose, the salinations of the soil, which started to degrade slowly and slowly, and the upper layer of the soil started to get washed away. This is one of the reason or the causes for the soil erosions. Then the second one is zone farming. And zone farming, as we know, is a common farming in a state also, where large scale area of land is being destroyed for agricultural purpose. That is, this type is called as shifting cultivations in the northeast part of India. And as the book says, it is a type of shifting cultivation practice on the hilly slope of Assam and other northeastern states in India. And also in a global wise, we can know that this also is practiced in Malaysia, Indonesia, and Sri Lanka too. And the third is nature of crops. Nature of crop means what are the types of crop that we plant that also causes to the soil erosions. That is what the crop is also responsible to the soil erosions. For example, now wheat have a low unit of index of soil loss, while crop like cotton, corn, soybean, and have higher unit of index. So this the nature, the way, the types of crops we produce or we plant also brings the causes or bring the soil erosions. The fourth one is faulty land use practice. Due to not proper use of land, that also brings the soil erosions. That is what? This includes indiscriminate use of soils for generations without putting back into the element of fertility and cultivations of unstable and hill slope. And the last is indiscriminate cutting of trees. The indiscriminate cutting of trees, actually, can be same as of the zone farming. So indiscriminate cutting of trees can be for many purposes, like for agricultural productions, for vegetations, or for supply of timbers, or fuel, and other purposes. So, in fact, this forest vegetation act of protections against forests of wind and water, protecting the soil from being washed away or blown away, and preserving the physical and hydrographic balance of nature. Also, the removal to the clear up area for agriculture, and has also led to the soil erosions. And the last from this chapter is indiscriminate use of chemical fertilizer and pesticides. Before this point, we have one point that is called desertification, which is washing away of earth topsoil due to the various factors. These are same with the soil erosions. And this is the last part of the chapter, that is discriminate use of chemical fertilizer and so now overall we can understand that due to all these problems what we have already explained are the reason are the cause behind the imbalance of the ecological system in India. And the last one, as I said, indiscriminate use of chemical fertilizer and pesticide. Chemical fertilizer and pesticide, in a common way, what we can understand is use of SAR, some chemical for better growth of vegetables, for better fertility of land in the productions of agriculture, agriculture products. All these things are the cause behind the ecological imbalance in many parts of our country, India. So this, what happened, this chemical fertilizer and pesticides are used in a discriminate way. Means what? These are used beyond what is necessary for the purpose or beyond what is necessary for the crops and for the vegetations. So first is that fertilizer is one of the crop energy, but this fertilizer even then has many disadvantages on the land or on the soil. The first disadvantage of use of fertilizer is what? They contaminate surface of they contaminate surface and groundwater resources and cause many other waterborne diseases like blue baby syndrome, stomach and cancer. And the second disadvantage is what? The quality of drinking water also deteriorated due to disposal of fertilizer into land, field site and land. And it also reduced the fertility of the land. The use of chemical fertilizer pesticide for the first particular year of production may be very good for the land, but this can reduce slowly the fertility of the land. And the fourth point is that reduce the proportion of organic matter in the soil. After fertilizer, now pesticide. Pesticides are what? Pesticides are chemical that are used to kill pests. That means the insects that will spoil the agricultural product or crop. To kill this, the pesticides are used. So pesticides are the creature that damage the crop and reduce their productions. Common pests like insects, rats, mice, bites, and diseases causes organisms like bacteria, fungi, and viruses. So the pesticides are all used for all this purpose. So common pesticides are what? The common pesticides are, let me just give some name for that. The common pesticides are Malathion. BSC and DDT. These are the common pesticides name. So what are the disadvantages of these pesticides are the number one, the non-targeted organisms are also killed and injured. Then the insects that do not die after the spray becomes resistant and produce the pesticide resistant generations. Due to killing of beneficial pests, which actually get killed due to the use of broad spectrum pesticide and which are helpful in controlling the dangerous pests, the newer problematic pests are allowed. Then this also what is the same thing like fertilizer, it reduces the fertility of the soil, then it brings the ecological imbalance and causes illness and slow poisoning in human beings. And the last is, and the last chemical fertilizer or the pesticide that is being used that destroy, that bring the ecological imbalance is eutrophication. Eutrophication is what? This process by which the content of oxygen get depleted in the water bodies. Use of this chemical, what happens is that it get mixed up with the oxygen and it depleted in the water bodies. This occur either naturally or due to human activities. So this happens, can be naturally or due to human activities, like human add excessive amount of plant nutrients, especially nitrogen, carbon and phosphorus. And the last is biomagnification. Biomagnification is what? It is considered as a kind of pollution. This is a kind of pollution like air pollution. So because of this pollution, what happened? This process is a tendency of pollutants to get concentrated in successive trophic or feeding levels of food chains as they move up the food chains. So the phenomenon, the result of this concentration, what happened is that these dispositions at the higher trophic level is known as bioaccumulations. These bioaccumulations take place in different organisms. They accumulate in the tissues and internal organs of larger animals when they eat them and thus move up the food chains, thereby increase the concentrations of the toxic compound. Thank you. That's all for today.